Hey guys, how's it going? Today is another sponsored video and I will be covering DCS, and I'm really thankful that I'm able to cover this stock as I see personally a lot of potential in it. So basically, DCS provides business solutions with intelligence, creativity, logical and innovation strategies that improve business efficiencies, productivity, reliability, and profitability. So as you can see, it's a wide variety of solutions that they offer. And recently, there has been a news article that they released that is very bullish, and I want to cover that. I'm also going to cover their investor presentation as there's a lot of great information in there. And finally, I'm going to be covering the recent price prediction for you guys, so definitely stay tuned for the rest of the video. Okay, so this is the announcement that DCS put out, and it states that DCS launches My Fleet Plus Vision with US Cellular. So let's get right into it. So DCS announced today that My Fleet Plus Vision has been approved for use on US Cellular's 4G LTE network. The launch of My Fleet Plus Vision will allow small, medium, and enterprise businesses to efficiently operate and protect their vehicles and drivers by providing real-time video within the My Fleet platform. Combining robust fleet management and real-time video allows fleet managers to take advantage of multiple points of vehicle and driver behavior. My Fleet Plus Vision allows fleet management to coach and train drivers based on key performance indicators, in addition to providing video intelligence in the event of an accident or potential litigation from an incident. So I thought that this was pretty bullish. I mean, the fact that they are partnering with US Cellular is pretty big, and I think that they'll be able to, I guess, expand this My Fleet platform and be able to garner more customers and clients through this partnership, I believe. It is just overall a pretty bullish announcement to see that they are, in fact, working with a new company. And I really like the concept behind the fleet management platform, so I also found that very interesting. I will now cover the investor presentation that DCS put out, and there's a lot of interesting information in here, so I'm going to cover a few slides specifically about their solutions and their multiple brands, and I will also cover the financials. So let's get right into it. First and foremost, this is their My Fleet brand page. Basically, it is a fleet and asset management platform that they offer, and they state that our clients offer My Fleet to enterprise / SMB transportation, construction, mining, delivery services, municipalities, school bus companies, and more. And as you can see, basically they have a lot of different features, such as, you know, GPS fleet and asset management application. They have a web and mobile application for both iOS and Android, and more. So this platform seems pretty good and seems pretty useful in my opinion. Obviously, I'm not really in that space or in that industry, but I can definitely see the use cases for it. And in the article we went over, it is very evident that there are use cases for it as well. So I feel like that is a pretty good brand, and we'll move on to the next one, which is My Sensor. So basically, it is a remote sensor monitoring, I guess, platform. In the features, it states that it is a turnkey sensor monitoring application available for both web and mobile. It has cross-cellular carrier compatibility, as a MyTag multi-sensor Bluetooth feature. It has real-time alerts and monitoring. And finally, they have comprehensive reporting. So basically, this is another one that I feel like it has a variety of different use cases. I mean, as it states, it's used for basically anything that has to do with, I guess, remote sensor monitoring. So that is definitely one that I don't understand as much of, but I can definitely comprehend that there are a lot of use cases for it and a variety of solutions that can be used with it. So that is the second brand. And the final brand is BrewC, which is a beer life cycle monitoring and control system. And it states that smart handling of temperature, CO2, pressure, inventory management, critical timing, and prevent after-hour pours or staff giveaways, a comprehensive inventory tracking system helping clients to reduce waste, theft, and non-automated interfaces, promoting better production. and the features are pretty similar to those of the past two brands. Now, I think that this one has a lot of potential. I don't know, obviously, which brand is the most successful, which is the least successful, but I can definitely see the use case for this, of course, and I definitely think that this one is the most interesting to me personally, but I believe all the brands look good. I think that all three have a lot of different solutions and a lot of different use cases, so that was obviously great to see that they have a variety of brands offering a variety of solutions. Now we will take a look at some of their partners, and as you can see, in terms of the channel partners, there are a lot of well-known brands that they are channel partners with. So for example, Sprint, Verizon, TELUS, and then strategic partners are Telit, A-Track, and Golden M. So there are definitely a lot of brands and partners that they have, some of which are very well-known, some of which aren't as known, I guess for someone that is not in that industry. But I still think it is just great to see that they are able to, you know, publish this and show the types of companies that they work with. And finally, the last slide we will take a look at in this investor presentation is, of course, their revenue and history. So as you can see, over the past 3 years, I guess, or 2017, 2018, and 2019, which is the last, I believe, year they reported, as you can see, the revenue has been growing every year. From 2017 to 2018, there was a massive jump. Between 2018 and 2019, there was not as much of a revenue growth. As you can see, in 2018, I believe it is around 15 million, and then 2019 is around 16 million. So it's not a lot of growth in terms of total revenue, but it is great to see that the cost of revenue went down, the gross profit went up, the research and development is in fact increasing, which shows that they are putting more money into developing potential more products or more platforms or reinventing their platform, stuff like that. That is obviously phenomenal to see as well. And of course, in 2019, they actually had some royalty income, which is also a benefit. So overall, I thought that this was a pretty good, I guess, financial slide to go over, and I didn't come across any real concerns. We will now go over the recent price action for this stock, and we'll be taking a look at the 1 month chart, as I feel like that will give you guys a pretty good sense as to how the stock has been performing on a monthly basis. So at the start of the month, the stock was, you know, around, I believe, $2, and then it spiked up all the way to around 2.7, 2.8 US dollars. And since then, it was a bit consolidating and then dropped, and then there was a massive spike again and then it dropped. So basically, the stock has, I think, been performing pretty closely with how other penny stocks and how other tech stocks have been over the past month. There have been certain spikes, there have been certain dips, and overall the past month for the stock market has been pretty bearish. So I feel like that is a major contributor as to why this stock is technically down for the month. However, I am personally bullish on the stock. I see the potential in the company. I really like the different solutions they offer, and I can definitely see the use cases for them, which I think is definitely good to see. But again, this is just my personal opinion, and I encourage all of you to do some research if you are in fact interested in the stock, so you can make a fair judgment for yourself. So that's the end of the video, guys. I really hope you liked it and found it informative. Let me know in the comments what stock I should review next, and I will see you guys soon.